Welcome to the subject Computer Application. Topic Encapsulation. For the class 10. Topics covered are: what is encapsulation, benefits of encapsulation, access modifier and its characteristics, scope and visibility rules. What is encapsulation? Encapsulation is a fundamental concept of object-oriented programming. Encapsulation helps the programmer in concentrating on the relevant details. Encapsulation makes the classes independent, and these can be reused without modification in other programs. So the wrapping up of data and function into a single unit is known as encapsulation. Next, we'll see benefits of encapsulation. Encapsulating related variables and methods into a neat software bundle is a simple yet very powerful idea that provides two primary benefits to software developers. One is modularity and other one is information hiding. What is modularity? Source code for an object can be written and maintained independently for other objects. Information hiding: the object can maintain private information and methods that can change at any time without affecting other objects. So these are the benefits. Next, we'll move on to the access modifiers and its characteristics. Access modifier in Java specify accessibility of data member, method, constructor or class. There are four types of access modifier. Number one, public. Number two, private. Three, default. Four, protected. So these are the four types of access modifier. Next, we'll move on to the public access modifier. Public access modifier is accessible everywhere. All codes can access the class, data member, constructor or method regardless of where the accessing code is located. Accessing code can be in different class and different package. We'll see the characteristics now. Public access modifier achieves the highest level of accessibility, and it can be accessed from any class in same or different package. Class on interface can be declared as a public. Look at a program here given. The class PUB, pub class, there we have declared a num variable as public and square variable as, sorry, it is not a variable, it is a method. Square method as a public. And we are accessing the num variable and square method in the pub1 class. Okay. So the pub class, the variable num and the square are in the pub class, and pub1 class is ready to access. So we can able to access it. Why? Because it is declared as a public. Okay. So next, we'll move on to the private access modifier. If a method or variable is marked as private, then only code inside the same class can access the data member or call the method. Code inside the subclass cannot access the variable or method, nor can code from any external class. We'll see the characteristics. It achieves the lowest level of accessibility and can access only limited classes, and the classes cannot be declared as a public. So here is an example, the same program what we have seen in the public access modifier. The only thing is the access specifier is different here. It is varied now. For the num variable, private is given, and square method, private is given. So when you try to execute this program, you cannot compile this program. Why? Because the variable num and the square method have private access in the class pub, and they cannot be accessed from pub1 class. Okay. So next we'll move on to the default access modifier. So default modifier is declared by not writing any access modifier. It is accessible only within the same class or within the same package, but not from the outside package. So here is the characteristics. So we'll see what are the characteristics. Classes, data member and methods can be default accessed. Using default specifier, we can access class, method or data member which belong to the same package, not belonging to the outside of the package. Okay, so this is the characteristics of default access modifier. So here is a program, the same program is given, but I didn't give any access modifier in the pub class. So the variable num and the square root in the pub class have no access modifier. So this means that they are assigned the default access modifier. Therefore, pub1 class can read the num and the square variable of the pub object, provided that pub1 and pub are located in the same Java package. So it can easily read the data members. Next, we'll move on to the protected access modifier. The protected access modifier, private member of a class cannot be directly accessed outside the class. Only a method of that class can access the private member directly. Okay, so here is some characteristics listed. So what are that characteristics? Methods and data members can only be accessed by the subclasses in other package or any class within the package of the protected data members class. So next, the class on the interface cannot be declared as a protected. So these are the characteristics of protected access modifier. So next we'll see a small picture here. See, the two classes have been stored in the package 1 and the class C is stored in the package 2. So within the package, how the classes can be accessed? See, the class A, if it is private, the class A cannot be accessible by class B. But for public, protected and default, the class A can able to access class B. Okay, but look at the outside package, which is package 2. Here, the class A cannot able to access the class C if it is declared as private, protected or default. Okay. So here is a easy view that you can easily understand what about the access modifier. So accessible inside the class. If the modifier is specified inside the class, whatever the modifier may be, you can easily access it. But if you want to access within the subclass inside the same package, all the modifiers can be accessible except private modifier. Suppose if you want to access outside the package, only thing is you have to give public. If you have given default, private, protected, we cannot able to access. Next one, accessible within the subclass outside the package. You can give either public or protected. It is not worked for if you have given default and private. Okay, so it's an easy table, you can go through it. So next we'll see a scope and the visibility rules. So it is the easiest way to understand what are the rules to be followed while writing a program. Suppose if you have given a public class and variable, so that class and variable is visible to all the classes. Okay, that is, it is because of the interest to the user. Suppose if you have given protected class and variable, so to the class outside the package, it is visible to the class outside the package that inherit the class and all classes in the package. Okay, so for inheritance purpose, we can give this protected. Next, default class and variable. It is visible to all the classes of the package. Suppose if you have given private, it is visible only within the class. Okay, suppose if you have declared a variable as a local variable, so the variable can be visible only to the block of the method. Okay, so this local variable will act as a temporary variable. Okay, I think you will be clear about the encapsulation. Okay, so that's all about this class. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you.